earlier video we looked at how you can use this new feature, the plotter feature in Mew, to show live data coming off the sensors on the BBC microbit. It's really quite neat. So all you need is a few lines of Python. I've just got four lines of Python here. Flash it to the microbit, just click on the flash button, the microbit starts flashing. As soon as the code is loaded, if you then go and look in the REPL, we should see, there we go, we can see data now appearing in here, numbers, readings from the accelerometer in all three axes. Not that interesting, not hard to, quite hard to actually sort of interpret that data. The cool function here is the plotter. If you click on the plotter button, it just takes any numerical data that is written to the REPL just using a print instruction and plots it on a graph. And here you can see it's plotting information from all three axes of the accelerometer. So if I have it that way up, you can see the orange lines at the bottom. If I flip the microbit over on its back, you can see the orange line goes to the top. You can see if I have it up sideways, I've got a blue line at the bottom. If I flip it sideways the other way, the blue line goes to the top. If I shake it up and down, you can see movement in one direction. If I move it from side to side, you can see movement in another direction. That's pretty cool, but a microbit is still tethered to the computer by USB. Wouldn't it be cool if we could set it free in some way? That's what this project here that I've just done does. So if I get rid of the REPL, I'll get rid of the plotter and go to this. I've got two other projects here. I've got a transmitter project here. What this does is it just sends the accelerometer readings as a string, and I've already flashed that onto this microbit here, which has got a battery pack attached to the back cunningly with a rubber band. And then I've got some receiver code which I'm going to flash onto the microbit that's attached to my computer. So if I now get the REPL back up, I'm going to flash the receiver code to my microbit. So, oh, should be flashing away. There we go, flash, flash, flash. As soon as it stops flashing, we should see some, if we're getting any data, if we're receiving any data. Down here, none appears. So we're not getting any data. Well, why is that? Why are we not receiving any data? Well, because we're not transmitting any data. So if I attach the battery pack now to my transmitting microbit, let's plug it in. There we go. We can see now over here, we're getting data receiving from the microbit that's actually not connected to the computer. And now if we get the plotter back on the screen, I can see real-time data now on my computer screen that is being received wirelessly from a microbit that's battery operated. This means we could do some physics experiments. We could attach this perhaps to a vehicle going down a slope that's being released. Science teachers will have more ideas than me about this. We could attach it to, I don't know, we could attach it to a rocket, you could attach it to a dog, you could do all sorts of things with it. And you can see in real time, you can get a reading of the data. Perhaps you could use it in some way to trigger an event when something happens. If somebody drops something, you could trigger something to happen, or perhaps just attach it to your dog. If your dog wakes up, maybe it would give you an alert. If your dog's sleeping on the sofa, you could use this as a movement detector, wirelessly transmitting data to your computer, all being received by the microbit attached here, and all done with just a few trivial lines of Python. This is stuff that you could easily do in a computer science lesson. There's only half a dozen lines of Python that need to be typed in, and it's up and running. I love the way as well that Mew just flashes the code straight onto the microbit. There's no dragging and dropping of hex files. It just works, and it's designed especially with teachers in mind. Features like that drag and drop of the code, and the fact that you can zoom in and zoom out the code so you can show it on a whiteboard or on a projector screen, and children at the back of the class can still see. Mew, it's a great project. This is a beta version of it. If you follow the links on the Adafruit website, you can find out how to install the latest version of it.